اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. ليلة الرغائب. It is Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah. They celebrate this night because the first Friday night of the month of Rajab is the night of Raghaib. It's the night of the conception of Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, where his holy physicality began to appear in this world through the womb of his mother, عليهم رضوان الله. So, we've heard from our mashayikh that this night is like a Eid for angels. Why is this night special? Because the one who was honored on this night is special, Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Everything that is connected to Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam becomes special. A general rule, a principle, anything. That's why his family are honored ones, because they have a nisbah to Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم through their physical being. That's why his ummah is honored ummah, because they have a connection as his followers. The general meaning of Ali Muhammad is every believer. The specialized meaning is his holy family. And the both meanings are accepted. So therefore, we as people who say La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, we have been distinguished and honored because we are the followers of the last prophet in appearance in dunya and the first prophet in khalq. He said, "Kuntu nabiyan wa adamu bayna al-ma'i wa-t-tin." I was a prophet and Adam was still being molded from mud. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's appearance. La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And in hadith Sayyidina Jabir, he says, أول ما خلق الله نور نبيك يا جابر. The first thing that Allah created is the light of your messenger, the light of your prophet, O Jabir. And so we are coming here. The more you strengthen that nisbah, that connection to sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the more you have affinity and love to him, the more you have understanding of the ni'mah that Allah has granted you of being follower of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the more your distinction increases as well. It is said Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam that he is happy to be from the followers of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, from the ummah of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. A prophet, min uli al-azm, values that he follows Sayyid al-Mursaleen over his rank of prophethood. And he shows respect to his family when in Damascus, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when Sayyidina Isa appears in Damascus at the end of time, when he comes down to Damascus, at the time there will be only a few believers with Sayyidina al-Mahdi alayhi salam. When Sayyidina Isa appears and imamuhum fihim, they were about to pray Fajr and their imam is standing amongst them and have him lead the prayer, and Sayyidina Isa will insist that Sayyidina al-Mahdi leads. So the one for whose sake all humanity is receiving rahmah, ar-rahma al-muhdat, rahmatan al-alameen, whether they know it or not, the one for whose sake all believers have been given a special distinction. One la ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah, will make you enter into heaven. One. Sallallahu, who taught you this? Why you who taught you to make salawat? One salawat upon him will garner, will bring on you 10 salawats from Allah. Who taught you to do this khair? Who is going to stand and intercede for you on the day of judgment? Who is teaching you how to live a happy life in this world? Look around you. See people who have no connection to Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. See the lives they lead. See the emptiness they have in their lives. They try to fill it with drugs and liquor and all kinds of things. They try to fill it with entertainment, with sports. It's a never-ending pit of emptiness and loneliness because they don't have that connection in nisbah. So alhamdulillah, we must show happiness. Tonight is Laylatul Raghaib. Because of him, because he is conceived in this night became the night of receiving what one's heart wishes. Raghaib is what you like. That's why dua is important in this night. The whole month of Rajab is a month of istighfar. But this night, and also the night of Mi'raj, and the first night of Rajab, Sayyidina Ali used to spend in worship. So inshallah, we are gathering here, we're going to do what our teachers taught us, which is Khatm al-Khawajagan, Dhikrullah, Salah ala al-Nabi, and Mawlid. And we will do a dua of Sayyidina Shaykh Abdullah al-Faiz Darsani, and we will do Salat al-Tasabih, Salat al-Tasabih, and Salat al-Shukr, inshallah. And we can pray also witr. And don't worry if your recitation is a bit slow. There was one lady one time, she was sitting with us and she's saying, "Sheikh, you're too fast. I'm doing my second Fatiha and you're saying salawat." And so I apologized. I said, then I went to visit Mawlana Sheikh Muhammad, and I was doing the second Fatiha, and he was done. So, alhamdulillah, it used to be the actual Khatm al-Khawajagan. The Sheikh will have the stones, and he will assign, for example, 11 Qul or 7 Fatiha. And he will give each one who is about to recite will have a stone. If you don't have a stone, you sit with presence. Your heart is in the room, not wandering. You're connected to your Shaykh, and you sit. And the only people that recite are people with stones. So when they used to say 79, they would recite 79. Alam nashrah laka sadrak. Not like the short zikr. No, we do 7. Alam nashrah laka. It used to be 79, so the Shaykh, he will have the stone, it will be distributed, and everyone who has a stone will recite Al-Nashrah. Those who don't have a stone, that's the Naqshbandi Khatm al-Khawajagan Dhikr. They will sit in presence. But now, with TikTok and Instagram, we can't keep our attention for 10 seconds. So they allowed also some loud zikr in the dhikr. But before it was only silent. People are coming here with whatever in their hearts of wishes for their dunya, for their akhirah, for their children, for their businesses, for their health, whatever it is that, inshallah, you are enjoying in life, or you are struggling. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala lift all afflictions from you and difficulties, inshaAllah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us billionaires, not in dunya only, but actually akhirah billionaires. Make us from مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصَّدِّقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءِ وَالصَّالِحِينَ وَحَسُنَ أُولَئِكَ رَفِيقًا. We said many times, the examples of the Prophet's companions and their love for Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And what made them so special is their love. And we mentioned many times one of the young companions, his name was Thawban. And he used to serve Prophet. Look, whatever he needs, he would try to be there to help. What family needed water, whatever Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was in need, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we are no one. So how am I going? If I can't miss you here, I can't be away from you here in this world, in this physical world, I can't be away from you for minutes or hours. How am I going to be for eternity away from you? And one reflects about on this hadith, just thinks about it. Sayyidina Thawban, he's thinking he's going to be in heaven, but still he is miserable, getting ill and sick, because he's thinking how miserable he will be in heaven away from Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He's thinking what kind of heaven is this heaven going to be if I am in one place and you are somewhere else. So this is how the companions were ushaq al-Nabi. That something for us to strive and ask Allah on this night. This is Laylatul Ghaib, it's Friday night. It's the first Friday night of holy sanctified month of Rajab. Ask Allah to make you from the beloved ones of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Ask Allah to fill your heart with His mahabbah. Inshallah, all of us to be with Him in Akhirah.